If you have driven in downtown Phoenix or right near central Phoenix, I guess, you have likely seen that Duke photography sign, and it's got a big temperature gauge on it. It's been one of the most iconic views we've had in the Valley since the 1950s. It's been on TV for dozens of times here since I've been on Fox 10. We'd always point to it when it was like 117 or something. But soon it may be gone, and there's something coming in its place that is not making neighbors very happy. So Ty is live with somebody. Hoping that we can go another way here. And is this 7th Street or 7th Avenue? I was trying to remember where it is.
7th Avenue, right just south of Thomas. And this is that sign you were talking about, Troy. We've done many a live shot in front of the Duke sign here because it has the thermometer here. So whenever it gets super cold in the valley or we're talking about those triple-digit record-breaking heat, we always do our live shots here at Duke's. It's become kind of an institution here in central Phoenix because of this kind of iconic building that's right here on 7th Avenue. But as you mentioned, it is set to be demolished. The owner of Duke's Photography sold the building, and he is going to be moving to a different location. And so in its place, some rumors have been swirling and some paperwork has been filed with the city for a chicken restaurant, Raising Cane's, but that is not sitting well with a lot of the residents that live in this area. And one of them is Gabrielle here. Gabrielle, first of all, how long have you lived in this neighborhood?
Hi, I've lived in this neighborhood for a little under 3 years, but I've lived in Phoenix almost my whole life.
So when you first heard the news that Duke's was going to be demolished and a Raising Cane's was going to go potentially in its place, what was your initial reaction?
Obviously devastated as a staple building in the city, and of course the sign. I just didn't sit well with only myself, but to kind of gain traction, I had to figure out how it felt for other people too. Like, was I the only one feeling this way? But my community and my neighborhood especially felt very strongly as well.
So Gabrielle, what is kind of the sentiment with your neighbors, and why do you want to not see this building demolished?
I just think, as it being here for almost 70 years, or I think a little bit of more than 70 years, it just doesn't make sense for them to tear down something historic and beautiful to replace it with something that's like shiny and new, when that doesn't necessarily reflect what this neighborhood around them looks like, including the Willow District too.
So Gabrielle, what is kind of, you've kind of been spearheading some different efforts, looking at ways that maybe you could do a petition, things like that. What have you been kind of researching?
Yeah, absolutely. So just understanding that a petition doesn't necessarily mean that a link can be sent out, and what the logistics behind it of sharing it mean. It's not as easy to share a link as it would be a photo. So just trying to figure out what the best way to get it out to everybody is, really.
Well, Gabrielle, thank you so much for taking the time to speak to us about your concerns, the neighbors' concerns here in the Central Phoenix neighborhood. We should mention that we did reach out to Raising Cane's for a comment. Still have not heard back from them, but that is what was the proposal with the city of Phoenix for some zoning requirements. Did have the Raising Cane's listed on all of that paperwork. So we'll send it back to you guys.
Right. You know, I get that. It's tough. It's a tug of war between, you know, what's been there for so long and, and, you know, progress, right? And just a changing way that people are probably dealing with their photography and those sorts of things. Ty, thank you. Interesting. Yeah.